Hey everyone, and welcome back to Gal. In this video, I'm going to be comparing Filmora Pro to Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, Filmora Pro is far less expensive than Premiere, but is it a worthy alternative? Let's start with what it has compared to Premiere Pro. If you're looking for something similar to the editing interface as Premiere, Filmora Pro has it. This is what Filmora Pro looks like when you first open up and start a new project. And this is what Premiere Pro looks like. Can you see the similarities? Filmora Pro, just like Premiere, also has dedicated workspaces that you can use for color, audio, text, and titles. You can also customize the entire workspace and then save it as your own. Filmora Pro also has a media panel, which is similar to Premiere Pro's project panel. Here you can create folders in your media panel and you can import video, photos, as well as music. Unlike Premiere Pro, when you open up Filmora, a timeline is already open, and it's not called a timeline, it's called an editor. So you can click on the gear icon to customize the editor's frame size and frame rate. And what I really like is that you can choose from multiple different types of presets, like Instagram, or even some GoPro settings. And I really like that it has Instagram because in Premiere Pro, they do not have those presets, just YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, stuff like that. And then for timeline tools, you can customize the track sizes and also rename them and insert new tracks. The editing tools include the selection tool, the cut tool, slip edits, rate stretch tool, and most importantly, the snapping tool that gets clips together. So all of that is the same as Premiere Pro. And of course, you can customize your keyboard shortcuts from the preferences panel, so you can use the same keyboard shortcuts as Premiere. As for playback and resolution, this is where I think Filmora Pro needs a little bit of work. So you can hit play in your timeline and you'll notice right now in my timeline, I have 2.7K footage shot on a DJI Osmo. 30 frames per second. But as I play it back, it gets delayed and it kind of freezes. And I've tried a few different settings. I've tried reducing the playback resolution, but there are still issues with the playback. So I think this is an area that can definitely use some improvements because the last thing you want to have to do is export to see how your final video looks like. In Premiere, you can render out the timeline just by hitting enter, and then you can watch it back without any issues. As for titles and motion presets, there are also title templates built in, just like Premiere Pro, except they are not called motion graphics templates like in Premiere Pro. You can also buy additional title templates from Wondershare's film stock library. Filmora Pro also has drag and drop effects, just like in Premiere Pro, and it has a lot more too. It has effects like light leak transitions, film grains, even some two-tone looks. In Premiere Pro, you have to buy those extra effects to get those. It also has all of the core color effects, including curves, LUTs, vibrancy, temperature, and more. And I was actually surprised by this. If you go in the color workspace, you can see that they also have scopes as well, so you can actually read the visual color data. It also has a controls panel where you can keyframe your effects and also just transform the basic clip tools such as scale and position. And of course, it has the export, so you can export a video just by using the in and out points or exporting all of the contents. Now, things that it does not have. You cannot have multiple timelines open at once. You can only work in one editor at a time. Also, there are no adjustment layers as of yet in Filmora Pro for applying universal effects to multiple clips at once. And it does not have a lumetri color panel like in Premiere Pro to make universal color grading and color correction effects. It does not have an essential sound panel where you can make universal audio adjustments to any type of audio. And it does not have audio hardware preferences to record audio directly into it like in Premiere Pro. But overall, for the money, Filmora Pro gets the job done. It's only $149, so it's definitely worth it. I do think, though, that it needs some major improvements, and I know that it's probably only in the beginning stage. Definitely needs some work on the playback and rendering, and some panels that will just help with overall color and audio adjustments. So what do you guys think about Filmora Pro? If you guys think it's worth a shot, you guys can use my link in the description to get it for free, and you can use all the functionality. It will just have a watermark when you export, and then once you decide if you want to actually use it, you can purchase it to remove that watermark. And lastly, a huge shout out to my long-standing patrons. Kofi O, Dexter E, Nova Nando Studio, Rod B, LK Loop, Vince O, and Jerry P. Let's get to 100 patrons. Just go to patreon.com/premieregal to join, and you'll get some free video stuff each month. Thanks so much for your support, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!